Oh, boy.
All we could get out of Regan was that he got the money from Lane gambling. I think it was blackmail. And when Lane threatened to go to the police, he killed him. Belden saw it, so he killed Belden.
Why should he take a shot at Meltzer?
He says he was cleaning the gun that went off.
Cleaning a gun in a car.
That's Regan's gun, and he insists it's his privilege to clean it wherever he likes. Now, I'm trying to hold on to Regan. But they've set his bail at 50 grand. Regan will have that up in 24 hours.
Fine thing.
Now, look, Pete. That Manton girl knows something we don't know. Otherwise, Regan wouldn't have tried to kill her. If he don't tell us, we'll have to get it out of Manton.
Get something out of Manton? Don't make me laugh. It's best too good to choke on.
Pete, I told her you were dying. She's out there in the corridor crying her head off for you.
She is? That's worth dying for. Well, almost worth dying for.
Listen, in the condition she's in, she'd even tell you her age if you asked it. You could get anything out of her if she thinks you're dying.
I'm sorry. You can't come in, lady.
Oh, I must see him. I must see him.
Let her in, Sullivan.
Oh, don't tax him too much. He's sinking fast.
Darling. Oh, darling.
Who is it?
It's Meltzer. What have they done to you, darling?
They've killed me.
The rats.
Oh, no, they haven't. You'll live. You've got to live. You've got to get strong and well for your career, your future.
Future? Future?
Yes, your future. Our future. You promised before witnesses that you'd marry me. You've got to live. Oh, I love you. I love you.
Ow! Oh.
The first death rattle.
Oh.
Who was it said, joy always comes to a man too late?
Oh, no. No.
Pete, oh. Boy, don't you want us to avenge you?
No, Mike. I forgive everybody.
That's what I call a nice guy.
Even the rat who shot you?
Even him, Mike.
Wouldn't you rest just a little bit easier if you knew why he did it? Just out of curiosity?
Oh, what good would it do? It's all my fault. Now it's too late.
Mike, you know Meltzer wouldn't hold anything back from a dying man.
Mr. Ames, isn't there something I can do for you?
Yes, Sullivan. Sing my favorite song for me. Home on the Range.
Sure. Oh, give me a home where the buffaloes roam and the deer and the antelope play.
Never to see the sun again.
A discouraging
war. I don't want to die. I'm too young to die. I want to feel the rain in my face,
the wind in my hair.
I want to smell the good earth.
Oh, Peter.
We could have made sweet music together.
He rose like a meteor, flashed across our sky, and then was gone.
Goodbye, Mike.
I'm not going to take this lying down. You're my friend, my best friend. And if it's no interest to Miss Manton, it is to me. I must have my revenge. Why? Why did Regan take a shot at you, Miss Manton? Why?
Oh, we were looking for Sheila Lane. He threatened to kill me if I didn't stop.
And did you find her, sweet?
Yes. She's registered as Sharon Lester at the Edge Hotel on 23rd Street.
Well, I'll be seeing you. I mean, when my number is called.
Home.
That's enough, Sullivan. Quite enough.
Where the deer.